Yeah, ne guys, it take one to be in a foreign country, walking down the street here in Washington, D.C. I had to reflect on my life. I went to Trader Joe to go and buy food so that I can make lunch for myself. Then I found myself crying, walking down the street, thinking about my family back at home, who I've gone through a lot. I am going to share this story not to make you guys look down or bad on my family, but I'm going to share it because I know that a lot of people are inspired by my videos, are inspired by my stories and everything that I advocate on this channel, and I don't want you guys to miss out on this. Especially if you are right now thinking of acquiring land back in the rural areas or going back to the rural areas, claiming your ancestral land, wanting to rebuild your homestead, your parental homestead, or your grandfather's homestead, or anything like that, for your own good, because you do see the benefits of what you are doing and how it will benefit your family as a whole. I've done that. I got backlashed for doing so. I got hated for doing so. Sometimes family members can become your enemies for nothing. Instead of realizing what you are doing as good, they look at it as competition. I am going to tell you a story of my life. Hi everybody. Welcome back to my channel and thank you for tuning in. My name is Velile. I am a lifestyle blogger from South Africa. If you're new on this channel, you are very much welcome and please do not forget to subscribe, like, share, and comment on this video. Thank you guys for tuning in. We are almost 50,000. Guys, we are almost 50,000. We are so close. Please share the videos. Please like the videos and please do subscribe if you do watch these videos and you are not subscribed. 48,000. That means we have a lot of people who are new on this channel who have probably just joined in and watching my videos while I'm here in Washington, D.C., in United States. Yes, I am a South African from the rural areas who showcase everything beautiful about South Africa as a whole, especially the rural areas of South Africa, showcasing the developments that have happened in the rural areas post-apartheid in South Africa, what people have achieved in the rural areas, the beautiful mansions that people have built in the rural areas in different villages across all nine provinces in South Africa. People are just doing wonders, and we have to just really say good job to those who are doing the good job. I am one of those people who have decided to honor my ancestral land and build a big homestead in the rural areas while I still have a house in the city of Johannesburg in South Africa. I balance between those two, and also I balance by being here in the United States because my husband works here in the United States. So I just balance between all of those and I showcase all of those. So if you have just joined my channel, watching the videos that I post while I'm here in Washington, D.C., showcasing what South Africans are doing while living here in Washington, D.C., or in the United States for that matter, the beautiful things that they are doing here and how they are having their hearts back home and also making sure that they take their money back home and build beautiful homes and businesses in the rural areas in South Africa as well as in South Africa as a whole. So I'm going to be giving you those kinds of videos. If you are new on this channel, please go back and watch some of my videos that I have posted on this channel. Talking about some of the videos that I have posted on this channel, I have posted so many videos, maybe not so many, but probably about 2 to 3 videos about my homestead that I had rebuilt for my parents who passed away. If you haven't watched that video, those videos, I'm going to put them down below on the description box as links so that you can relate to the story that I'm telling.
But those who have been here since the beginning, and thank you so much, the Village Gang Gang, for your love and for your support and for taking this channel this far. I am really thankful for all of that. So what I am going to do today, I'm going to give you a story of my life, how I have suffered hate from some of my family members for doing something great, going back to my ancestral land in the village in rural South Africa, reclaiming it and making sure that I take from where my parents left and rebuild the homestead while it was dying and they were watching for 20 years. It's such a sad story. In 1992, my mother passed away. So I came back to South Africa in 1992 to bury my mother, who had passed away. I had been in London for that time, that period, because my husband had gotten another scholarship to go and pursue his master's degree in at the London School of Economics in London. So I had to move from the United States with my children and follow him to London. London was a good idea because it was closer, much more closer to home back then. So I knew exactly that I have more support if I am in London. It should be easy for me to just fly overnight and get to South Africa. If anything that needs me in South Africa, I have to go for. And it did happen. My mother passed away while I was in London, so I left to go and bury my mother. When I arrived back home, my mother, as you know the story that I had related to you guys, that we had a home in the city, in the township in Pietermaritzburg, that my mother had built into a big home for us with so many bedrooms compared to where she came from in the rural areas. So she had relocated, not relocated, but we were back and forth between the rural areas in the village and the city. And my mother loved the village so much. You know, as a child, I frequented between the village and the city where my mother and my father were because of work. As you know, there is a story I did relate to you that my mother and my father lost that house because they couldn't manage to pay the bond after they had extended their home and asked for loan at the bank. That made my mother really suffer a lot of heartache. And she ended up developing a heart disease and she passed away of heart problems. So when I came back to bury my mother in 1992, I promised myself that I will honor her legacy. I will make sure that her house become as beautiful as she would have loved it to be, even though it would have been in the rural areas. So I came back and my mission was to, just after burying my mother, to try and make sure that I rebuild the home, because they had just started building it and it was really not a nice home compared to what my mother had built in the township in Pietermaritzburg. So when I came back, I knew from the day when we were about to bury my mother, that probably me coming back to rebuild this homestead might give me problems from what I had to endure from one of my family member, who is really somebody I look up to, who's older than I am. But I told myself, you know what, I am married, let me just mind my own business, let me go back to my home in Johannesburg and do what I want to do with my life. But you know, knowing that your mom and your dad really wanted to settle in the rural areas again, because that's where they came from, and they wanted to build a beautiful home for us, but they couldn't because of the situations and everything that I had spoken to you guys on the emotional video that I posted probably about 3 or 4 videos back. You will see it when I tell the story about how my family lost everything in the city but regained it back in the rural areas. This story I'm telling you because I want one of you who is suffering backlash from any family member who is looking at you now going back to claim your ancestral land and building your home in the rural areas and trying to give you probably a negative outlook to everything that you are doing. Please don't be discouraged by people, because I was not. 20 years after my mother passed, I was waiting for my siblings, watching them because they are older than I am, to see if they are going to do anything, and nothing was happening, including to build tombstones on my mother and my father's grave. I had to ask one of my nephew to help me so that we can put money together and we can do both of the tombstones for my mom and my father. But my elder people, I'm not going to say exactly who in terms of gender, because people are just really hating out there, and probably I might get a backlash again and probably be more hated. But I don't really care at this time, because I'm in a position where I have achieved what I wanted to achieve for my parents, and my parents are looking down at me and they are happy. So 20 years down the line, I went back to the village. I spoke to my brother. Oh, I love my brother, because as much as he's the firstborn and older than all of us, he is very understanding, because also he grew up in the rural areas. He knows exactly how my mom wanted to build that house. And he has been so supportive to me in so many ways. I am here in the United States right now. I have two homesteads that I need people to look after in the rural areas back in KZN. And I have people who are working in both of them. My brother is always there to make sure that my parents' home is looked after and it is very well kept. And the people that I've hired to look after the house are doing exactly what needed to be done or needs to be done. I am in a position where I don't have any fear anymore for what people are going to think of me. I have done so much and I am going to keep on doing so much. My story is that I have endured a lot of hate. Sometimes it hurts deep down inside, because you love your family so much, and what you do, you are trying to, you know, to carry the legacy of your parents, but there will be family members who are just going to hate on you doing that for no particular reason. If you watch my videos way back when I introduced you guys into my parents' homestead, I did mention that I have built that home to carry my parents' legacy and to make sure that even our grandchildren have a home. Even when things go wrong in the city, they have a place where they can go back and just really relax and know that they have a home that my parents built for them, even though I had to carry all of that and rebuild the home and try to maintain it. I'm still maintaining it. Electricity bills, a person who works in the garden to make sure that the house is kept, how I had to go back home and rebuild some other things because of how the house is positioned, and how also the storms from the weather, sometimes they destroy homes in the rural areas. So I've done that, guys. I'm very proud of doing that. I pride myself every single day, regardless of the hate that I get from some of my family members. But I do keep on soldiering towards the goal of making sure that that house will remain there. Even for those who are hating on me, who are haters at this time, but their children will enjoy the benefits that I have created for all of our children. That's what keeps me going. That's what I have told myself that I'm going to keep on doing. Keep on doing the right thing for your family, even when they are hating on you for doing the right thing. Sometimes jealousy, or I don't even want to say jealousy, because people take this as if like, oh, just because you had money at that time, we didn't have money and you did this. Sometimes they saw you starting something, but they never came and said, we are going to help you to carry on doing this thing. It's the right thing. It's very sad when you don't get that assurance from your elder siblings. I mean, like, praise to my brother, who is older than all of us, but has been supportive to me. I love my brother. If he's watching this video right now, I just want to tell him I love him for loving our parents, for loving our culture, for loving the rural areas, for understanding what I wanted to do, and for him also being a guidance to myself even after my parents had passed away. And I also want to say to my family members who are watching this video right now that I did this for you and your children, and you will always be proud of me when I'm dead, because people do not honor you when you are still alive. Instead, they hate you for doing the right things. I am doing this video because I want to encourage a person who's going through what I have been going through. I am still going through that. They are still hating on me. They have never visited the home since I have rebuilt it. They have never. They don't bother and they don't want to. I don't know why, but anyway, I do have those family members who are appreciating what I've done, and they've been coming, and I enjoy sitting there on Boxing Day, a day after Christmas, with my husband, just the two of us, putting a braai and just sitting in my mother and my father's home, enjoying lunch on Boxing Day, because during December, it's always hectic in my own homestead. I also have family members that come over into my home around Christmas, and we do enjoy Christmas together. So when everything dies down, the following day I go to my parents' home, I cook for my husband and whoever cares to be around, and we eat and enjoy, and the legacy continues. Guys, I have enjoyed so much hate, and those who are hating on me, they know exactly why they are hating me. They are hating me for nothing. I am in a position where I am very happy for what I have done, and I am encouraging them to just love me for what I have done, because seriously, I've done the greatest thing for the family, and I don't know how long they are going to keep on hating for something that is so great. We have a homestead that is looking so good right now. So sometimes, guys, so look at those who are proud of you, who are congratulating you for what you have done, and keep on moving on, because what you are building right now, it will remain to your family for the rest of your lives, including your children and probably your nieces and nephews and their grandchildren and great-great-grandchildren and whoever. But you've seen the stories that I've put out. I've told you what owning the land in the rural areas mean to so many people, and how much it is an asset that you can really look at as an asset, like I am looking at it as an asset in so many ways, whether financially or emotionally, or also as a very good thing that has ever happened to our family. I'm very proud of being a rural girl. I'm very proud of being from the village in the rural areas for that, because my parents probably might have not left me a lot of money, but they did leave me land for me to be able to do what I have done for them right now. It is my home, it is my home, and also it is my parents' home. I have rebuilt the home for my parents, so the legacy continues. Thank you guys for tuning in. I hope you have been inspired by this video. I hope you are going to look at your life and then try and motivate your life and encourage your life to move on and do what you have started to do. Never ever feel guilty for doing the right thing. Bye guys.